Hello! In our previous video, we presented our take on Bad Apple meme. Bad Apple is a Japanese dance pop song originally featured in one of the arcade games from the Touhou series. Since 2009, the distinctive silhouette shadow art video has inspired an extensive list of remixes. We will not go into details on the history behind the meme. Among the links below, you can find better places to explore it. Instead, we will explain how we made our hyperbolic render. Hyperbolic geometry is a kind of non-Euclidean geometry. Like spherical geometry, it is a geometry of a curved surface. However, contrary to the sphere, we have negative curvature, in other words, a saddle, everywhere. Here, you can see an embedding of a fragment of the hyperbolic plane. What you have just seen was hard to be neatly described mathematically. For convenience, we will use flat models of the hyperbolic geometry. These are sorts of maps. We also call them projections. The Poincaré disk model is probably the most common one. For example, you could have seen it in the works by Escher. The projection here is conformal, which means that the angles and shapes are correct, but the distances might be distorted. Even if it looks like we have a sort of fisheye effect here, in reality, all hexagons and heptagons are of the same size. The Poincaré model is not the only option to visualize hyperbolic geometry. There are other conformal projections of the hyperbolic plane. For example, here is the half-plane model. And here is the band model, which will be important for us. Again, it is conformal, so all the angles and shapes are mapped correctly. Interestingly, it is a hyperbolic analog of the Mercator projection, you know, from geography. And yes, Mercator projection is also conformal. And so on. We can use other shapes with neat mathematical descriptions. But can we obtain any shape? Speaking informally, according to the Riemann mapping theorem, the hyperbolic plane can be mapped conformally to any shape that does not have any holes. Okay, that's nice. But finding such a mapping is still a challenge. So here is how we do it. The Bad Apple video consists of frames, each of which consists of 480 times 300 pixels. There are 30 frames per second. We work with each frame separately. Let's start with a very simple shape, an apple from our video. For the purpose of this presentation, we will be using larger pixels. We have pixels inside our shape and pixels on the boundary. We split the boundary into two parts. We will be mapping our apple to the band model. So, the top part of the boundary is mapped to the top of the band, and the bottom part of the boundary is mapped to the bottom of the band. In a conformal mapping, every pixel maps to the average of four pixels around it. This corresponds to a system of equations. We have two equations for each pixel, for its x and y coordinate. Now, we just need to solve that system of equations. We use Gaussian elimination for this. One interesting thing about Gaussian elimination is that how fast it is depends on the order in which we eliminate the variables. To solve the problem efficiently, we eliminate variables in a specially chosen order. But we will not go into details on how to find it here. Okay, so that's how we get the mapping for a single region of a single frame. However, if we mapped each frame independently, we would not get an aesthetic animation. The mappings of the same region found for consecutive frames should be similar. How to achieve this? Let's use the fact that the conformal mapping from the Riemann mapping theorem is unique up to the isometry of the hyperbolic plane. For our video, we simply try random isometries and measure their similarity. After we choose the most similar one, we apply smaller and smaller changes to get even more similarity. Still, there are some things we need to take care of. How to map the outside region? We said that the Riemann mapping theorem works for shapes without holes. So, time for a small cheat. We simply cut our region along the shortest line from the hole to the outside boundary. Actually, for static images, our tool, NewConformis, has some tricks to map shapes with holes. However, they are not really applicable to videos. They require more assumptions, for example, that there is a single hole, and in BetaPro, there are regions with multiple holes. Another issue comes with long narrow stripes. As you can see, a small change at one point leads to significant changes in other points along such a stripe. This makes it difficult to find a mapping that matches the previous frame at every point. Also, we encounter some numerical precision issues. In the case of static images, we had to devote significant effort to deal with these issues. For the video, we have decided to just subdivide such long stripes, and that gave us more degrees of freedom. But enough talking about theory, time for some practice. Here is one screenshot of our tool in action. Unfortunately, our algorithm is not easily parallelizable, that is, it works on a single processor. As a result, on our hardware, rendering the Bad Apple video on a single processor would take about 30 hours. To speed up the task, we split the video in fragments and we render them in separate processes. Of course, this could cause some loss of continuity, so we manually split at times when it should be not noticeable. So, this was a brief explanation. For more resources, see the links in the description. Thanks for watching!